Hey, what's up, guys? I'm here with the one and only TBC. Goes by a 7-car 2003 on 2+2. And you've been playing poker for a while now, right?
Yes.
How'd you get started?
When I was growing up alone at home with my mother, we'd sit around the house and play cards and board games all the time. So even though she didn't gamble and I didn't play poker as one of those card games at the time, I got to be really good at games.
Playing cards, yeah.
So that's what I play in Uno and Skip-Bo and Work and games like that, non-gambling games. And so that's what I got to be good at. So when I got to be 18 and I was living in Toledo, Ohio, and they were having these Catholic Monte Carlo nights and the Knights of Columbus and the VFW and the American Legion for charity, I taught myself to play poker. And at first I wasn't winning, and eventually, after trial and error enough times, I finally got myself to start winning it. That was back in the old days of 1 to 5 stud. That was the game back then. Well, actually, at those charities, there was only like $1 and $2 stud at the time.
Okay. So you've done a lot of traveling, right? You've been pretty much all over the country.
Yeah, pretty much most states around the U.S. that had poker, I've been to at least once in my life.
That's cool. Yeah, you're kind of a nomad. You don't mind moving around and checking out different poker locations. What's your favorite? Does it change?
My favorite rooms are the Nugget in Vegas, the Peppermill in Reno, the El Dorado in Shreveport, and Greek Town up in Detroit.
Cool. Yeah, Peppermill's nice. Should be there in a couple weeks. Cool. So now, as far as like beginning players, what would be like your top 3 tips for beginning players?
To not play too many hands. If you first started playing No Limit, to probably practice in like 1 cent, 2 cent, or 2 cent, 5 cent game online, and become familiar with the game first. And to make sure you always have plenty of buy-ins and not try to play with too few of buy-ins.
Yeah, that's right. Micro management. Yeah, because you've been doing longer than most people, right? You've been at it since before the Money Maker.
I'm one of the very few people to start it out instead.
Yeah, but you're still around, so that's pretty cool. Inspiring. I remember reading your blog years and years ago, just being like, man, he's traveling here, and it's always kind of fascinating. And you've got a lot of people, a lot of different players.
I still do the blog. I have like about maybe one post up a week now. I used to put up like 2 or 3 a week. Now it's down to like 1 a week. But I still get like about 2,000 readers for every post.
Yeah.
A lot of the people even remember me before I had the blog, back when I used to be on Part-Time Poker, which was a staking website back in the day, in the mid-2000s, like 2005 to 2009, when I was playing on PokerStars before they shut it down. And,
yeah. So that's pretty cool. Yeah, I mean, when did you start blogging? Like,
I eventually, for the blog I have now, I've had for like about 5 or 6 years when I moved it over to Blogspot. But,
I think I did.
I've had
to
blog at one address in the past.
Yeah. Super cool. So you pretty much chronicle all your journeys and like go over your bankroll swings. And,
I don't really mention hand histories as much as I should in my blog, like most, a lot of people do. Basically, I talk about how I'm feeling on certain things at the time. And
Yeah. Pretty much, yeah, there's no rules. I mean, you can talk about whatever you want.
Yeah.
You don't have to.
The life of a low-stakes grinder is greatly different than the life of a high-stakes grinder or a tournament player. Totally different.
Yeah, you can watch like Day on the Grinder if you want to see that side. But this is like, I feel like it's more down-to-earth. A lot more people can relate to people, you know, playing 1-2, 2-5, stuff like that.
And there's a lot more people playing those stakes,
yeah,
too.
Yeah. So it's kind of cool because you can get a window into each of these different poker locations that you've been if you read through your blog, which I think that's cool. Because you've been to a lot of places I've never been to that, you know, I'd love to check out. So that's inspiring. So, do you have any goals for the summer?
Well, my main goal is to get that 15K that I'm at back up to 20,000 and to cut down on my expenses while I'm staying at.
Alright. Yeah, I think you might be able to find something that's cheaper. Oh, but you said you really concerned about safety too, right?
That's why I ended up paying about twice as much for that stayed within what I really should have. That's why I've got it.
It's worth it for the extra peace of mind.
Yeah, that's what I said. I waste a lot of money on stuff just for peace of mind and stuff. For example, when I'm in the Uber, I never use Uber Pool. I pay the extra $2 or $3 or $4 every time to ride in the car by myself instead of paying for it.
Yeah.
Just because I feel more comfortable that way.
It's a small luxury, isn't it? Cool. So, do you have any plans going forward the rest of the year?
After my time is up here in Vegas, I'm considering most likely going back to Toledo to stay at my friend Ray's house, in which case we'll be going back and forth to the casino in Detroit every day.
Okay, cool. You say it's such a lot grinder. Have you ever met a lot grinder?
Lot grinder? I don't think so.
Yeah, he's got a blog on T+T as well. So, any last words you'd like to share with the poker community?
You might want to give them the link to my blog so they know how to find it.
Yeah, I'll definitely link it below in the description and on 2+2. Check it out. Lots of good stuff in there. And, appreciate your time.